Hello, friends. Happy Monday. I hope you all had a good weekend. Sorry about the lack of an episode on Friday. Hopefully I can get back into the swing of things here and have another 5 episodes for you this week. I was going to start off, like I normally do, by recapping the journal entries up until this point. But I discovered, upon doing the test recording, that I cannot access my menu right now, and I stepped out the door to see if I can access it there, and it triggered an automatic event. So I guess that's what's stopping me from going into the menu right now. It was just a dialog box, and as soon as I saw it, I loaded my state again because, you know, no spoilers. So instead, I'm going to finish exploring this house. We are in the house of the village elder who has asked us to go into a cave and slay some monsters. Northwest end of the village. Okay. Who will remember that? Hello. As soon as he heard about the magic knights, Lucino took off for that scary cave. I wonder what was so urgent. That might be Lucino who was talking to me when I stepped outside. I'm not sure. Oh. Well, that's an observation that we've had before. Huh. I guess they repeat sometimes. Why down here? Why not? Well, maybe it's a magic plant that doesn't need any sunlight. Maybe it's made out of escudo. Same. Oh, that's another repeat. I guess I can't blame them too much for recycling some of the observations. There's a lot of stuff to look at. I like the consistency here. I think we saw one of these lamps in Precia's manor that was turned off, and I think it was Fu who remarked, how does it work without being plugged in? And now we see some down in the basement where there's no natural light, and they're turned on. Nice little detail. Also, nice transparency effect with the light shining through these windows here. That's the power of the Saturn for you. Alright, I checked out everything in here. You really are the legendary magic knights. The monsters all turned and ran back into that cave. I'm not kidding. Okay, that's not Lucina. That's the village wizard or something. Right, so Hikaru was unsure about whether they should spend time helping the people of this village because they have their important magic knight quest to find the escudo and activate the machines and everything. And now they're starting to realize that helping the people of Palizu village is magic knight duty. Because that's what the magic knights do. They help people. Ah! Well, that's the plan, ma'am. Hopefully once I get into the cave, this weird slowdown goes away. I think it's just because there's a lot of animation in this area from the rustling of the trees and the fountain and everything. Have I talked to these people? Well, I've got good news for you. They are totally gorgeous studs. I guarantee it, ma'am. Okay, I think I was in here before, but the dialogue has changed now that I had that key event. Alright. So we're on number 8. I don't remember if I played number 7 or not. I should have checked beforehand. Just for completeness sake, I'm going to go ahead and play all the number 7s, then all the number 8s. And start with Hikaru, as is traditional.
Precia made us weapons out of Escudo. What's better yet, Mokona is coming along with us. I'm so happy that Mokona's coming. I'm really getting attached. Leaving will be sad. But I guess that's a long way off. I'd better just keep my focus on this quest.
We all have our weapons of Escudo now. Precia told us to develop the weapons and unleash our hidden powers. Mokona is supposed to guide us. Personally, I think Hikaru's already too attached to him. Besides, that fluffball is nothing but a self-centered, attention-sucking rat, if you ask me.
Now that Precia has crafted the weapons of Escudo for us, we are to build them with the strength of our minds. Reportedly, that is the key to unleashing the ancient machines. It's a big task, but I think we'll all do our best.
When we reached Palizu, the mayor of the village begged us to slay a monster in a nearby cave. His plea was so sincere and his face was so sad that I had to agree. I guess we're off to kill a monster.
Hikaru agreed to kill a giant monster in a cave near Palizu. I wonder if we really have the time to do something that risky. I thought we were supposed to be headed for the sea to find the first machine. But that's wishful thinking because Hikaru always gets her way.
I believe the best way to increase our mind power and the strength of our weapons is to help those in trouble. Hikaru obviously feels the same way because she's volunteered to help the people of Palizu.
Alright, a little tension between our protagonists here, but I'm sure that they will overcome it with the power of their minds. Let's also see what Clef has to say. Only a very few people know that Princess Emerald has been kidnapped. It is your duty to protect that secret by not mentioning such things in the villages you visit. The secret is safe with us. I knew I could count on you. Emerald has chosen wisely. Alright, anything else? Since Emerald has been bound, Sephiroth has drifted to the edge of eternal destruction. If the people of the land grow fearful, their fright will manifest itself as a terrible beast. Hikaru, Umi, Boo, you alone have the power to snatch us from the jaws of this terrible fate. Please, you must rush to claim your destiny as the Magic Knights. You are our last and only hope. Jeez. No pressure or anything. Okay. Alright, well, northwest was it? Well, since south is the way we're not supposed to go, let's start by going south. Hello! I'm listening. I think I talked to that guy before. And yeah, this is just a dead end. Really looks like I should be able to go this way, but as of right now, I cannot. Can't jump over this rock. Looks like this path keeps going if I can clear out the rocks somehow. Maybe with some sort of machine. And this was where that jerk lived, right? Yeah, maybe he has different dialogue now. Alright, buddy. I just wanted your opinion about the appearance of the legendary Magic Knights. Alright, that's a dead end. Huh. probably need to start by going this way. No? That's an invisible wall, huh? Wow, that really could have been telegraphed a little better. So there was like a magic barrier up here, right? Oh, maybe the wizard guy. Yeah, that must have been what happened. Now that he was aware that the magic knights are here, he took down the barrier so they can get to the cave. That seems plausible. Hi. Oh, you're that creepy kid from the cutscene. It is said that the legendary magic knights will defeat the beast dwelling in this cave. Do you really think they can do it? Good luck. You'll need it. Very unsuspicious. Alright. Time to transition from adventure mode to combat mode. I think we get some more good music in this cave. I really like the town music too. All the music in this game is good. Oh, hi. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is my jam. Wow, that little riff there really sounds like The Legend of Zelda, You Solved a Puzzle tune. Not as much once it keeps going, but like when it starts off there. Awful lot of animation in this cave too. Not as much slowdown, it seems. Okay, I don't actually have to worry about these holes. I don't think. They're just decorative holes. Alright. Clef, give us advice about this cave. If you combine your power, you can make the dreams of our good people come true. Even with the obstacles strewn in your path, I have faith you shall overcome them. Can you be more specific, please? I was trying to give you a pep talk. Thank you. I could go for some pep. You're welcome. Rude people these days. Alright, that's not something I can examine. What about this? Alright, let's go. Let's go. Ah, great. Oh, and that just worked us back to the beginning. Excellent. So do I just have to trial and error my way through these cave exits / entrances? I figured I would walk through one and come out one of the other ones. What the? Oh, okay. Health potion. Completely recover hit points. Nice. I wonder if that's just whoever the active character is or all the characters. Also, I read the manual since the last video, and there are 8 of each of these 7 rainbow gems. So, 8 times 7 is 56. 56 of those to collect. Ah! Okay, so that brought us back here. I mean, I'm gonna have to go through each of these entrances eventually. Huh. Ooh. Well, the block pushing puzzle that I cannot solve from this side. At least it's bringing us back to this room instead of the very beginning. That's nice of it. Alright, let's confront this gentleman. It's probably Lupico. Well, I gotta see where the last teleporter goes. Alright, just back here. Should have seen that coming. Alright, as long as I hug the wall, it seems like we're safe. The other wall, not the wall that the spears come out of. Alright. Okay. So, just gotta Sokoban this block onto one of these pressure pads and then stand on the other one. The beach ball looks like a threat. What are you girls doing in here? Don't you know this cave is dangerous? Take that ball, for example. It looks like something which might be mildly fun and entertaining. But I know that it is actually a fearsome steel ball of rolling death. Now you will learn that unfortunate truth firsthand. Run, 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 cowards! I read that last part like Sinistar, because I assume that that's a Sinistar reference. Beware, I live. I was right. It was dangerous. Oh. Wasn't expecting that to work. I think I got a strike. Okay, so that opened up another path. That's nice. That's almost 60 small gems. What's up, horseman? They're carrying morning stars, which I recently looked this up for a totally unrelated reason, that I didn't know that I would be encountering them. But a mace is a smooth ball at the end of a stick. A morning star is a spiky ball at the end of a stick, and a spiky ball at the end of a chain is a flail. Or a kind of flail. There are multiple kinds of flail, but the chain makes it a flail no matter what is at the end of it. It could be multiple spiky balls or multiple non-spiky balls. Puzzle solved. Love that advanced enemy AI. Oh, they do kind of charge at you if you just stand there. All right. Come back for you. Hey. Don't swing that thing at me. You might hurt someone. Curses! These infernal children are beginning to fray my tender nerves. Listen up. Hasn't anyone taught you three to respect the wishes of your elders? I warned you before, but now I'm commanding you. Do not advance beyond this point. What's happened to the final... Ah, I had to ask. Hey Clef, what do you think about what's going on here? You can jump farther than usual, if you have enough room for a running start. I know this might seem insultingly obvious, but I wanted to remind you of it anyway. You're right, Clef, it is insulting. And besides, only one of us is blonde. What? who has brown hair, but I don't. In the tempting cave, everything is not as immobile as it seems. Try pushing barriers. Finally, specifics from the master of non-specifics. It's about time, Clef. So I'm not super happy about a blonde joke, but it doesn't even make sense because none of the three is blonde. Oh, well, look at that. All right, running start. Thank you, Clef, for the advice. Apologies for Umi. I mean, like, a blonde joke isn't the most offensive thing in the world. It's just, it's insultingly lazy humor. Like, talking about insulting. Alright, let's go. Oh, I thought that was going to be actual spoken dialogue, but no, just the burp. It was very important to hear that. Haha, now there is no chance for those infernal brats to heal from the fountain. Haha! Burp. Woo-ha! Time to make a little fountain of my own. Ugh. What's this guy's deal? Other than that he sucks. Clef, advice. Okay, same advice. Oh, hi. Alright, let's keep going with Fu, I guess. Since she's my main. Nice little jingle there. Oh boy. Almost looks like I can make that jump up and to the right without needing to land on the platform. Well, maybe not. Man, that thing's scary. It's using runic magic on us. You guys doing okay? Hikaru and Umi? Seems like you're struggling just a little bit. Ow. I'm in pain. Well, you know what to do about pain. Oh, that's a full heal. Nice. I mean, for the number of magic points it costs, I kind of hope it would be. Hello. What have we here? There's a mirror here. It's Clef's face in the mirror. Through this mirror, Fu, I shall bestow a new magic upon you. You will now command the Green Squall. It will summon fierce winds with which your enemies can be tossed about. Oh, that's interesting. So I wonder if whichever character I examine the mirror with is the one who would get the magic. Oh, so I don't have the magic points to cast anything. So I can cycle through my magic with the Z button. Do I have, like, information about the magic? Like, how much it costs and stuff? Hurricane Force, Gust of Wind. All three recover their strength. And then one magic yet to be discovered. Okay. So that's like a hit everything on the screen kind of spell. That's nice. Golden Axe style magic. Y'all hang in there. I've been waiting for you. Check out this magic. I think you'll find it's a blast. Haha. Oh. Yep, that's a blast, alright. Nope, that didn't work. Nope. Oh, do I have to grind for magic with Fu? Okay, so maybe that was like a Fu-specific magic thing. I guess if I had examined it with Umi or Hikaru, it probably would have just switched to Fu. Alright. Go kill some enemies until some of them drop magic. I'm assuming that's what I have to do there. Because he's attacking us with wind. So I guess I have to fight wind with wind somehow. Maybe it'll be nice and give me a big magic drop. Not from these worms, though. They seem to only give you gems. No! Well, I kind of wish I hung on to my magic instead of demonstrating it, but hindsight is 20/20. So now that I know that the mirror magic is specific to one character, I will conserve my magic points after finding new ones. Wait, it would be nice if there was like a fountain where I could recover my magic or something right before the place where I'm required to have magic points. Ow! Right. Or if like it just gave me some enemies that dropped magic or something. I mean, I guess I'm practically back at the entrance of the dungeon, so I can walk to the fountain in Palizu Village and see if that is in fact a full heal. And then it shouldn't take me too long to work my way back to that dude. I mean, the town doesn't have an inn, so it would make sense that the fountain would be the thing that serves that function. And the dude who's preventing me from proceeding is on our side, I think. Hey, look at that. I was correct. Like, the evil kid hasn't even shown his face. I mean, he's shown the bottom half of his face. I don't know, maybe the old dude is under evil kid's orders or following his orders or under his influence or something. It's okay. I'm having a chill time with this music. A little backtracking never hurt anyone. And I'm continuing to grind money during the process. Granted, I haven't found anything to spend it on except for, like, health potions. But there might be something more valuable to spend it on later. Let's go. I suppose these are unicorns. Unicorn people, since they're horses with a single horn. They sure don't look like unicorns. Other than the horn. Let's go. I'm sure as soon as I get past this point, it's gonna refill that fountain with water somehow, right? That seems to be telegraphing that. Actually, you know what? I wonder if this is like, if it's one of these kind of situations. Nope. Okay. Well, it was worth a try. Still just waving away, huh? Alright. Well, that guy's been dealt with. Surely we'll never encounter him again. Tune in tomorrow for the conclusion of the Cave of Desire. Or whatever this area is called. Tempting Cave. Right. It is very tempting. See you later.